Good morning. This webinar is based upon the RoboRoach experiment that I and two of my cognitive science teachers did recently. This is based upon robotic cockroach or a cyborg. We did it because, as stated, one in every five people will or do have a neurological disorder. So to spread awareness about the basic body system and how to take care of it, it is really important to do these kind of experiments. How did we do it? By providing BCI, or we provided neurostimulations, microstimulations inside the body of the organism by external methods. Why them? Because Periplaneta americana, or cockroaches, are really abundant in our country, very easy to find. Another main reason is they have a bigger ganglion in their head, which can be considered analogous to human brain. Even though our nervous systems are very different, but the functions are basically same, as they transfer the signals throughout their body through or by the use of neural pathways of electrical activity, or as we call it, spike, as we do it in our body. Another important aspect is their morphology. The antennas are important for us to implant the electrodes, so it is easier to provide the microstimulation by external means. The steps to follow are: first, anesthetize a cockroach by putting it in ice water till its movement ceases. Because it is cold-blooded, it cannot bear much temperature hike or inflation, and then gets into a anesthetized or unconscious state. Next, we rub the head part of the cockroach with sandpaper to remove the waxy chitinous layer from its head to implant the electrodes. This, as shown in this picture, these machines are pasted or glued upon the surface which we recently rubbed, and then the electrodes are as shown in the video. Next step is to implant the antennas into their respective electrodes. The third antenna goes to the dorsal side by penetrating a hole into it. This picture shows it perfectly, the placement of the three electrodes. This video shows the process. In this slide, the last and the most important step is seen, which we couldn't perform. We introduced the PCB backpack and connected with the smartphone to control the cockroach as per our wish. What did we learn through it? The neural control of behavior. We saw real-time respondents of the brain to the sensory stimuli in cockroaches. Learning and memory. We saw that when we try to give periodic microstimulations, then the cockroaches in about 20 minutes adapt to these stimulations, and then they cannot be controlled further. Stimuli selection. We can vary the range of frequencies of the stimuli and see the effects. Finally, I thank all my teachers to support me in this experiment and to lead me to learn a lot. Thank you so much.